I may mention this on social media at the end of last week. Nothing in depth, nothing crazy, just a short post about what I thought it would take to try to make a guess as to which mountain will start spinning its list first. This is Tim from SkiRexMedia.com once again, and I thought we would go over what we would need to make that guess, and then maybe at the end, I'll take a guess. I think the first thing we need to take into consideration is the weather, and the things that affect the weather. For us here in the United States, that is a function of how far north any of the mountains are, and the elevations that those mountains sit at. I know, there is more to weather than just those two things, but we are going to keep it simple for this episode. Now, being as far north as parts of New England are, we always have a shot at getting the title for the first mountain to open each year, and it has happened before. Killington was first like 4 years ago, and Sunday River, Maine was first 9 years ago. So it does happen, especially with improvements in snowmaking tech, but we'll get into that a little later on. Anyway, with our position on the globe, we here in the East always have a chance at opening first. But if you look at a globe, or any map really, you can follow the latitude lines all the way to the west and see there are a bunch of places that have the same advantage, or even have more of an advantage. We all know where Alaska sits, making them the furthest state to the north, which could put them in the running for the title each year. But let's take the idea of looking at a map a step further and turn it into a terrain map. You take a look at all the wonderfully squiggly lines and you can see the other factor we are talking about at the moment, the elevation. We all know that there is almost no higher elevation in this country than what one can find in the West. Again, I know there's going to be more to it than what I'm about to say, but to keep it simple, the higher the mountain, the colder it is at the top, the more of a chance that the snow can fall. Also, those bigger mountains are high enough to stop the weather from getting up and over them. Again, just to put it simply. One of the reasons they get all the snow is because the snow can't push any further east. As an example, I'll tell you a quick story from when I was living in Las Vegas. For those that don't know, Las Vegas sits in a bowl surrounded by mountains. Now, that bowl is at a decent altitude. I mean, our apartment was 2,400 feet up. Now, that's already higher than some of the summits here in the east that see snow every single year. But one of the reasons Las Vegas doesn't get the precipitation is because it runs into the mountains that surround the city, and it doesn't make it to the Strip. Oh, and just so it's said, if I'm wrong about that or anything else, and you are a meteorologist and you want to correct me, you can. I really don't mind being wrong. Yes, I could go fact check myself, but I'm in the middle of the story, so I'm just going to let it ride. Anyway, while I was living in Las Vegas, a friend of mine and I were up early one winter's day and decided to go get donuts. As the sun was coming up and the fog was moving away, we could see how much snow had fallen on the mountains to the west. I mean, if you looked northwest and turned to your left, all you can see is just a ring of snow. That wasn't just Mount Charleston either. That was across the tops of all those mountains. And all those mountains were 6,000 feet or higher and right in the path of the storm. So the point is, the big mountains are colder at the top and in the way of the storms. Now, this is also true for the Rockies, which I'm thinking sees more first opens than just about anyone here in the U.S. Again, I could fact check that, but I'm in the middle of doing this. So, if you know I'm wrong, help me out and tell me. All the contact links are in the description. But if I'm right, that means the Rocky Mountains traditionally is the first region to have the first open ski areas each season. Which brings us to the second factor one should take into account when making a guess. Tradition. Really though, if we think about it, the tradition of being open first is a function of location and weather. Even if a mountain could claim to be traditionally the first to open, that would be dependent on having an early winter that dropped enough snow to make it happen each year. One of the things we know as skiers and riders, other winter sports enthusiasts, and just humans in general, is that weather isn't always consistent. One winter could start in October and last into the early summer, as we saw with some areas for the winter of 2018 and 2019. But that could be followed by a winter that starts in February and ends in March. There's just no real consistency to the weather, no matter where a mountain may be. So what does that mean? Well, it means that no single mountain can be traditionally first. It has to be a region. Even to that point, using the word tradition would be kind of a stretch. In fact, the more I talk about it here and think about it, this probably shouldn't even be a factor in trying to guess who will open first. As I said, this would have to be a function of weather and location, and we already took that into account back at the beginning. So we should probably move on to something that might actually make sense to talk about. Now, that something would be snowmaking systems. Seems pretty obvious, right? In fact, I probably should have brought up snowmaking instead of the idea of being traditionally opening first, huh? Well, either way, snowmaking is going to be a huge factor as to who gets to open first. In fact, it could be the one thing that gets some mountains open early. Again, the weather is inconsistent. It could be wicked cold out coming into October, but the sun could be shining each and every day. There are no clouds in sight, no storms are in the forecast. But being that it's the 21st century, that's not going to stop any hill that has modern snowmaking systems. Well, I mean, it's not just because of the 21st century. The snow gun was invented in the mid-20th century, but you know what I mean. Snowmaking is out there, and the hills with the most guns and the best systems with the biggest ponds and lakes have the best chance to open first. Those mountains also have to have the crews to run that equipment. Always show respect to your local snowmakers. The work that they do could almost be considered an art form. I think it could anyway, and I bet some of those crews would agree with me. But if a hill doesn't have the equipment or the crew, then there could be a winter that the hill doesn't have snow. Think about it, two mountains right down the road from each other, close enough that a person could see one summit from the other. Let's say that the snow is running late, but it's wicked cold out there. Cold is a you-know-what out there. And yes, I know I swear on here from time to time, but I'll leave those other words out for now. Anyway, it's cold enough at these two mountains, but one has a killer snowmaking system and crew, and the other doesn't. Which mountain opens first? That's right, the one with snow guns. And beyond that, there really isn't anything else that we need to take into consideration when we try to determine who's going to be open first. It's all about location and weather and the mountains that have modern snowmaking equipment and the people to run them. That would be, most likely, the high-end resorts that have the resources for snowmaking that are up in the high mountains that are a little further north. It's really as simple as that. Although it really does make one wonder why anyone would try to make that guess. You know, why would any of us be interested in who opens first? Well, that's going to differ from person to person. Some are just a bunch of ski bums or winter sports enthusiasts that are taking the guests for the fun of it, or to plan their first road trip to hit the slopes. Others would be in the industry and have to worry about the business end of it. Being the first to open for a season would make for great bragging rights and might sell some extra tickets during the season. Still, there are others that belong to both of those groups and like to gamble. I love the gamble, but I don't think I've ever bet on a mountain being the first to open. You know, for as much as I like to gamble, I don't think I ever would. Why not? Well, it's because I don't think anyone could accurately predict which hill is going to be open first, no matter what one takes into account. It really is just for the fun for me. Having said that, and being a betting man, I'm going to say it's going to be a mountain in the Colorado Rockies. That is where the smart money should go, in my opinion. To be honest, though, even though I'm calling for a mountain in the Rockies, that's not where my hopes lie. Well, not necessarily anyway. For those of you who are fans and friends of Ski Rex Media, you might think that I'm hoping that it's going to be here in Vermont. Well, again, not necessarily. I do have the hometown locals' love, and I push the Ski of the East ideal just as much as anyone from New England. But the first to open doesn't have to be here. I think it would be awesome if the first to open this year was a hill that typically isn't the first to open or that we wouldn't necessarily hear about as the first to open. I'd love to see it be a little single-run local park hill that only has a rope tow or a T-bar at the most. The kind of place that is set up on the outskirts of a family farm that put up the lift for local kids to take up their skis and boards and even sleds for a few runs after school. The kind of tiny little place that Norman Rockwell might have painted back in the day. I think that'd be amazing if a place like that got the bragging rights for being the first to be open. But that's just what I think. You might disagree, and you might have your own guess as to who will win the race to open and why. And with that, I think we have found a place to close this episode, since I always give out the contact information at the end of each episode. If you have a guess as to which mountain will open first, or would like to share who you would like to see open first, you can email SkiRexMedia at SkiRexForever@gmail.com. That's SkiRex, the number 4, ever@gmail.com. You can also find SkiRex Media on Facebook and Twitter at SkiRex Media. You can, of course, go to SkiRexMedia.com, which has all the contact links and more than a few places to leave comments for me to find. There are also links to all those in the description, so you don't have to memorize them right now. You'll also see that along with however you listen to this episode today, that there are other ways if you prefer. This podcast can always be found through the Buzzsprout site, through Spotify, through iHeartRadio, and I even put episodes up audio only on YouTube. So if you would prefer to use one of those services instead of the one you use today, you can do that, and those links are listed in the description as well. With that, have a good morning, day, evening, or night, depending on when you listen to this. Again, this is Tim from SkiRexMedia.com, and I'll catch you on the next one, or maybe out on the hill. Later.